Hey guys, and welcome back to another Unfiltered Gamer board game review for CGE's Galaxy Trucker, the second edition, meaning the remastered version of the original edition of the game. This is a 2-4 player board game that plays roughly about 30 minutes or more if you're playing the way we normally play. It's for ages 8 and up, and it's made by CGE. This game here is all about constructing a ship that you're going to use to travel the galaxy. This truck, or a galaxy spaceship, is going to be acquiring crew, aliens, and other useful tools like blasters and thrusters in order to set sail on their adventure. There are multiple different types of adventure cards in the game, and you'll be utilizing these to basically acquire valuable resources. Maybe you'll visit a planet and gain some type of cargo, or fight against pirates and defeat them by gaining cosmic credits. Or perhaps you're going to encounter a meteor swarm and have pieces of your ship get blown off into outer space. Travel through, finish the adventure if you can before having to give up, and then collect the rewards in the game. The rewards involve getting farther along on the trip, having the prettiest ship, having the most valuable cargo, and not losing pieces to asteroids, laser beams, and other sorts of disasters that you will encounter throughout the game. Will you have the most cosmic credits at the end of the game, or will you at least not have negative credits at the end of the game? Find out in the game Galaxy Trucker Second Edition. To set up a game of Galaxy Trucker, give each and every single player a player board. Start with, as a beginning player, the round 1 spaceships, and note that the board can go from round 1, 2, and 3 by flipping it and rotating it and opening it up. Each player is going to get a starting space that you'll place in the middle of your ship, and that space is going to have a color. Also give each player a spaceship that you'll place on your board, and one you'll place on the main game board. Speaking of the main game board, set the main game board out. It's available for everyone to see. This is what you're going to be doing throughout the game as you gather things and as you move across the board, and it also has kind of a player reference attached to it. Take all the tiles and place them face down within reach of all players. Set the timer aside, as well as any of the credits and adventure deck cards. Additionally, you're going to go ahead and set aside any of the aliens, the batteries, more ship crewmates, 2 dice, and then all the 4 different types of cargo: red, yellow, green, and blue, which are basically cargo of certain value. Go ahead and place any additional player boards for players you're not going to have in the game aside, along with, of course, the rulebook and the reference board that you can utilize if need be in the game. Then you're ready to begin. Okay, so how do you play a game of Galaxy Trucker? Well, it's pretty simple. Based on the board you're choosing to play as, the starting board, first, second, or third round board, and there's 2 of them, you basically can flip them over to determine which one you want to play, then you're going to take a number of cards based on that board and set them into 4 piles. In the original starting board, which is not the beginner mode, you're going to get these guys here. This, you're going to get 2 ones, and you'll place them in each of the different areas on the board. And there's 4 areas, meaning a total of 2 times 4, 8 different adventure cards. As you play additional rounds, unique encounters are going to pop up, and you'll be utilizing the 2 and 3 cards from the 2 and 3 adventure decks. Then go ahead and make sure that all players are ready to go by taking the timer here. Now, the timer is optional, and if you're playing your first game, I suggest not even using it, just letting players complete their ships. But how it works is you place the timer on the start space. Everybody has all the tiles face down in front of them, along with their player board, and you're going to go ahead and have one player take the timer and flip it over. And now, the beginning of the game begins. You're going to be taking out tiles one at a time, looking at them, and then choosing to place them on your player board. The one main rule of the game is you have to connect a piece with another piece. You can't simply have it somewhere set off in space that's not adjacent to another piece. And also, when connecting, there are 3 different connector types: 1s, 2s, and 3s. 1s connect with 1s, 2s connect with 2s, and 3s connect with everything. They're wild. And you're going to be building a spaceship utilizing the tiles that you see fit. Some other rules include thrusters can't have other pieces behind them, just like you're using a thruster to push your ship away. And additionally, you might want to have lasers shooting from the left-hand and right-hand side of your ship, along with the front of your ship, and most of the time, front. There's a ton of different choices and pieces that I'll explain when I talk about my review of the game, but basically you'll be building this ship that is going to kind of be traveling the galaxy when you finish. As this timer runs out and maybe a player finishes, they can take that timer and choose to flip it as soon as the timer runs out and flip it to the next space. And then it's going to continue running out of time. When finally that timer runs out, that will end the round and players will finish their ships, and they'll take all the adventure cards and they will set them aside and shuffle them. Based on when players finished, they're going to take their ships and place them on the main game board in the position in which they finished. So if red was first, they'd place in the red position and in one position. Green was second, third, and fourth, meaning that the first player is going to be in the first position and the last player to finish is in the last position. After they shuffle their adventure deck, they're then going to utilize the ship that they have built in order to travel the galaxy. And how that works is one of the players, maybe the moderator or maybe the person who's in front, will draw a card. And that card is going to instigate what the players are going to do. Like, for instance, open space. All players are going to move the total amount of thrusters that they have available to them. Then, after they do that, this will get discarded, and whoever is in first place at that time is now going to draw the next card and reveal it and do what it says. Maybe they will encounter slavers, and the first person will have an opportunity to defeat them. If they have 6 lasers, they will defeat the slavers, gain 5 points, and lose a certain amount of days. Days being in reference to this board here, basically whenever you lose days, you'll go down on this track here. And if they're unsuccessful in defeating these guys, they'll lose a certain type of crew, or they're going to lose some cargo, and it'll tell you. In this case, it's 3 crew. And then, of course, the card will get discarded, and once again, you will rinse and repeat. And you got another one here. This one here is asteroids. And you'll do them from left to right, top to bottom, in the order in which they are perceived. So I'd have a big meteor asteroid coming down, and then I have a small one, and then I have a big one. Meteors and asteroids slash laser beams all inflict damage in certain ways and have certain requirements as to how they hit the ship. If they're coming face down, you're going to be looking at your ship from north to south. If they're coming from left to right, you'll look at the left-hand side of your ship, and so on and so forth. You'll roll the 2 dice, and then based on the value of the accumulated rolls, so in this case, if I rolled something like a 6, I wouldn't look and check my board here. And in this case here, if I rolled a 6, and it was coming from top to bottom, this is the 6, it's going to go down and it'll hit the ship down below in the 6th position. If it is able to destroy a piece based on whatever it is, you'll lose that piece and it will go into your discard. Anytime you lose pieces, it'll go to a discard area, and if you're not playing with the beginner mode, those pieces will count against you in as far as credits go in the game. After all the cards in the deck have been utilized, you're going to then end the round, and you're going to check and see how far along is every player. First place will get a certain number of credits being these points here, second, third, and then fourth. Then the prettiest ship, the player who has the least amount of connectors outside of their ship. So basically connectors that are not connected to something, whoever has the least amount of those scores victory points. Next is your cargo. For every player who has a red cargo, they'll score 4 points for each. Yellow is 3, green is 2, and blue is 1. Accumulate those total amounts and give each player their respective value in cosmic credits for their cargo. And then last but not least, you're going to lose points for each of the pieces of your ship that were blasted off in the game. Finally, you're going to have these things here. These are like awards or trophies that instead of actually accumulating for the fanciest or prettiest ship, you can take these based on completing a certain goal. If your ship was the biggest one built, or if it had the most this or that, or the least amount of cargo spaces, there's a whole different type of these guys here. And these guys will score you 2 points for completing them. And in addition, as you move from round to round, if you would like to, you can basically try and hold your title and upgrade it to the next value and score additional points. And go from a 2 to 6 to 12 points, I believe, for scoring these treasures or trophies, which are not in the original base game. And then if you'd like, you can go ahead and head to the next round. You'll reset everything, just as I explained in the setup, but for the other round, taking this board off and flipping it over to give you the number 2. And then you're going to also take your board out and turn it to the side in which you're playing with. So in this case, if I went from 1 to 2, I'd play on the 2 side next. And then from 2 to 3, I would go to the 3 side. This is the big boy ship. This is what really gets the galaxy going for you guys. And of course, it gets more and more challenging with new adventure cards, new things you can do, and more dangers you'll have to face throughout the game. And that's pretty much the idea of the game. Each round, you can stop playing, and whoever has the most tally credits wins. And of course, everyone wins as long as they're not 0 or negative. And then, obviously, of course, if you want to play a 3-round game, which is what I suggest, whoever has the most credits at the end of all 3 rounds is the winner of the game, Galaxy Trucker. Oh, okay, let's talk about this one. Galaxy Trucker was one of my all-time favorite games back in the day. Before I was a reviewer, before I played in a lot of modern board games, this was one of the top 10 games I started playing, or one of the first 10 games I started playing, along with Catan and Cosmic Encounter. I love this game. This game was so much fun. It didn't matter whether I won or lost this game. All that mattered was that I had fun and the people around me had fun. And every single time we did, we made up tons of house rules to this game as far as we are not allowed to pick up and place down a piece and not utilize it. Instead, you have to use every single piece that you place as opposed to putting them back down and switching them up if I want to. I use somebody else's piece. It's just if I can play it, I put it down. Another rule of thumb was we only got one timer, and so we can kind of like twisted it up and made it more and more challenging. But then as they started making more expansions, we started having to do that less and less because the game started getting crazier and more difficult and a ton of more pieces. I have all the original base set games, all the expansions except for the secret missions, but everything else I had, and there is so much content from those games that I never thought I'd ever want to play another version or increase my supply or capacity of Galaxy Trucker. And while that's probably true, this is a remake or a remaster of the base game. This is going to come with all the base game pieces and everything that you would normally associate with the base game, but in a fresh, shiny new box. And in fact, this is going to be replacing my base game. Why? Because this has way better components. Everything in this game is handcraftedly better. The only thing I would probably say maybe is that these little spaceship dudes are probably not as nice as the original ones, but the aliens, the cargo, energy is pretty much the same. The way the boards are laid out and the fact that they're not super huge anymore and you can kind of unfold them to change the way in which it's going to look for you but not take up a huge amount of space. I have an entire box full of just these boards. No longer will I need to do that because this is going to instigate all that value right here. All the pieces are better quality and they're printed better as well. All the cards are shinier, easier to read. They've got a nice sheen to them and easier to understand. It used to be where the graphic design was not as great on the cards. Not that I couldn't understand them. You can, definitely, but they're kind of more formulaic. This one is kind of cleaner and more fun when looking at it. For instance, the meteors now that has a certain distance and you can look from top left to right, top to bottom kind of thing. And it illustrates exactly what we need to know with as little amount of art as possible, cleaning it up. As opposed to a bunch of lines and drawings and all that kind of stuff. And then of course, just the vivid imagery on these cards is way, way, way better. Overall, this is a much better, more enhanced version of the original one. If you got an old copy of Galaxy Trucker sitting around, you really like the game, but you want it to be a little cleaned up, a little better components, then this is one I would suggest you getting. I am super glad I got this game from CGE. If I knew about how nice the quality for this game was before even receiving it, and I wanted to spruce up my Galaxy Trucker collection, this is definitely what I would pick up because, as far as I'm aware, all the pieces do work with the original ones, and you can kind of mix and match them. And in fact, I can just kind of add them all together and make a huge game out of it and maybe play like 50 bajillion players because it really doesn't matter. You'd have to just draw multiple cards on an adventure or something like that. But it is excellent. I really, really like this. I love the game Galaxy Trucker. It's all luck. It's all randomization. Yes, there is luck reduction. There's minimization as far as what you can see what happens to you. The cards that are placed face down. You can kind of look at them while building your ship, but you lose time building your ship. And it provides a lot of choice when it comes to that. But in the end, you're not sure where you're going to be. You're not sure who's going to have more thrusters than you. You can't predict everything. And because of that, you just need to play to have fun. And if you lose, it's okay. Sometimes you're gonna have a roll of the dice that just affects you negatively. Maybe you get hit one time in a terrible space and your ship gets blown up, whereas somebody else gets hit 10 times and it's not really that much of a big deal to them. You don't rely on the whole, I need to have the best or be the best in this game. It's not about that. What this game is about is enjoying the puzzling experience, which is exciting, it's fast, you're constantly trying to make a pretty, fun, exciting ship that's gonna help you throughout the game, and then when the game comes out and you're done, you're ready to go on your adventure, expect to be blown up and watch as you and your friends all get frustrated as things just do not work out. The best laid plans fall apart right in front of your eyes. And that's what I really, really enjoy about Galaxy Trucker. I love the fact that there's a ton of different pieces in the game. And like I said, I want to describe some of them. Some of them are going to connect with your ship, things that will allow you to gather cargo. Others are going to be boosters, and they're going to let you move farther in space. Sometimes you're going to run into a red cargo, which will let you gather the red, or in fact, they're a wild, but red only go in red. Aliens. Aliens will benefit your ship, but need to be connected with a crew quarter. You can also establish new crew members in your ship with crew quarter areas. And you're also going to have lasers. Another thing to note is there's batteries in the game, these little like tic-tacs here. when you're building your ship, there's going to be a ton of different green things, like shields. There's going to be boosters with green. There's going to be lasers with green. And in order to power them, when a card comes up that wants you to do it, you have to use a battery. So for instance, if I have two thrusters and an energy-powered thruster, a battery-powered thruster, the battery one goes twice, but these two only go one each. So I can go two on my own, or if I spend a battery, I can go a total of four. And you have that option, you have choice. Do you wanna go ahead of players, be behind them, utilize your batteries as much as you possibly can without expending them all when you need a shield? Because shield can protect you from lasers. They can also protect you from certain types of asteroids. And so that choice is available throughout the adventure. When you wanna go to a planet, what cargo you wanna get when you want to not go to a planet? Do you wanna send your ships, your crew off to salvage a ship? And then of course, get a ton of credits, but you've lost a ton of crew, and you have to be careful because sometimes you have to give up. Maybe your middle of your ship gets blown up, or you lost all your crew members. You're going to be just sitting in space. You've lost that specific round. And so your choices amplify the likelihood of that happening if you get greedy in the game. And this game is all about greed, competition, greed, a little bit of not working against each other, but also not working for each other as you're taking the pieces. But in the end result, you want to be the one that crosses the galaxy the best possible way you can with the most cargo you can, and of course, make out on top in this game. Overall, the second edition is much better than the first. If you want something that looks sharper, is cleaner, is better crafted, and of course has nicer components, then this is the one for you. If you're satisfied with the base game, however, and you enjoy it as is, but you can just keep the base game. You're not going to be missing out on any additional components for this other than, I think, these little trophy things. I don't think I've seen these before. And of course, the way the boards are built and the front and back sides of these things here are a little different as well. Additionally, too, if you've never played Galaxy Trucker before, I have high praise for it, but I can understand how extremely irritated people can get when they build something beautiful and then they watch it get torn apart. For me, it's awesome to see that happen, but it can and will happen to you in this game. And if that's not something you're prepared for, or to be in first place and then be utterly demolished and in one card, then it might not be for you as well. Nevertheless, Galaxy Trucker is going to be a favorite of mine from here on out. It's a game I will always be willing to play because it's something that I can just sit back, enjoy myself playing, and then watch and just see what happens. It's like a choose your own adventure, but in board game form. Yes, I love this game. Thank you for watching another Unfiltered Gamer board game review for the game Galaxy Trucker, the second edition. If you'd like to purchase this game, there's a link down below in the description where you can pick it up from CGE or Amazon if I have an affiliate link. You can also go and check out the website, unfilteredgamer.com, blog posts, giveaways, Kickstarter lists, and more. You can also go ahead and check out moonshellgame.com. We've got Moonshells coming out pretty soon here. It's we're waiting on the last finishing results of the deluxe edition for my wife's game, and then we'll have a new game out for you as well. And last but not least, Patreons, thank you so much for supporting us. We do greatly appreciate it. It does greatly help us out. Subscribe to the channel, hit that subscribe button and the bell notification button. All right, guys, that's all I got for you this time, and as always, I look forward to traveling the galaxy with you next time. But you're going to be the one that blows up, not me.